TypeScript running natively in Node.js. Yes, this is a piece of a dream many people had, and it's now a reality. Having TypeScript support is the most requested feature by the community, and this request has finally been fulfilled. In this video, I'll show you how the support is working in the version 23 of Node.js, which was just released. Having TypeScript running natively in Node.js is so incredible that I brought the TypeScript initiative leader from the Node.js project to this video to explain why this has finally happened, what we can expect from it in the near future, and the projects behind the scenes. For this video, I've created a relatively complex project to show you that it's really working, using one of the most powerful features of TypeScript to date. So go ahead and drop a like in this video, let me know in the comments what you'd like to learn here in the channel, and let's dive into the video. Well, it's been a long time since my last video in English here. Don't forget to look at the playlist in the channel. I have a lot of breathtaking tutorials for you to dive into after this video. I'm part of the Node.js project, more specifically in the Node.js native test runner team. Although I'm not as active as I used to be, something great has happened. Back in 2023, I introduced the mock timers feature in the Node.js native test runner, and it's recently promoted to stable. That was a big achievement for me, as this was my first end-to-end feature implemented in Node.js core. It's wonderful seeing how Node.js has been evolving with such quality and velocity in the past few years. If you're feeling lost and didn't know that Node.js now supports TypeScript, don't worry, I'll give you all the details in this video. Essentially, the decision was, we are not going to rely on TypeScript configuration files. We are not going to run type checking or have transpilation steps like the common TypeScript workflow. Instead, we use a technique called strip types, meaning that when you run your project, Node.js removes the TypeScript types, turning them into plain JavaScript.
But Erick, if Node.js won't do any build step nor validate my code, how is that a good thing?
The main idea is to give you better experience in JavaScript projects, where your editor would show you the main issues while you're coding and provide better intelligence. Nowadays, VS Code often gets confused and can show you what are the functions or variables available on an external file, leading us to a lot of attempts back and forth. It's common to write a function, import it into another file, and only realize after running the project that there's an extra word in the function name leading to the famous undefined is not a function error. To fix this, many people would write JS docs, which are comments that tell VS Code or other editors what that function receives and returns. JS docs are pretty good, but from the dev experience perspective, it's pretty bad. VS Code should be able to map your instances and let you know what is available, and that's how TypeScript support in Node.js will help us. And what about performance? How is it going to affect the project? Node.js contributors decided to follow the same strategy and even use the same library as Dino, called SWC or Speed Web Compiler. It was created to take TypeScript or JavaScript with the latest features and generate code that works in older browsers. So performance won't be an issue, since this is a battle test approach used by various runtimes out there. Marco Ippolito is part of the Node.js technical steering committee and is the front man behind the TypeScript initiative in the Node.js project. He's also an active speaker, and I've had the pleasure of meeting him at several conferences around the world. He has built a project roadmap on how TypeScript should be in the future. He also got a lot of feedback from the community and gathered suggestions to finally make this possible in the Node.js core. I bet you're curious to hear what Marco has to say, right? So come on in, Marco, tell us, who are you?
Yeah, so my name is Marco Ippolito, and I'm a member of the Node.js Technical Steering Committee. Lately, I've been working on the native TypeScript integration on Node.js. So if you haven't checked out, well, this is the time.
Nice. So this is why we're here, right? Because it's been a long time I've been hearing, like, we should have TypeScript in Node.js, but we finally got it. So why this happened now? And is it the same TypeScript we are using in other platforms? There's some magic behind the scenes happening.
Yeah, so there are multiple factors that contributed to having the TypeScript integration finally landed. First of all is TypeScript becoming extremely popular in the ecosystem. Also, a lot of work on the CJS, CSM interoperability on the Node core. So a lot of small factors allowed me to create the PR that integrated TypeScript. It's not the usual TypeScript that you use because we decided to go through a different path from other runtimes, which is strip typing, which basically means that you take the TypeScript that you know, remove everything, all the types, and the output, if it's a valid JavaScript, it will run. Otherwise, it will not work.
Yeah, in my opinion, this is amazing because it's trying to improve the developer experience, right? We're going to improve your IntelliSense on VS Code, and we get everything that is very pretty good from TypeScript. However, it's not TypeScript running, right? So what is behind the scenes? Is it any library behind the scenes?
Yes, so we use SWC, which is a very popular TypeScript transpiler, which is also used by Dino. So it has been battle tested, let's say. But we use it in the form of WASM, and we have a slightly different configuration from the standard one. So, for example, in the normal strip types mode, you cannot use enums or namespaces, but you don't need source maps because we use a magic technique, which is called blank spacing, which takes all the TypeScript and replaces it with blank space. So we don't lose the original location and we don't need source maps, which makes it faster. But as a cons, if you want to use enums, namespaces, or TypeScript features that require transformation, you need to use the dash dash experimental transform types flag, which enables it, but it also enables source maps.
Amazing, amazing. In your opinion, how important is to have TypeScript in Node.js?
So, I think this has been one of the most requested features in years. We can also see that from our yearly survey. This is going to improve the developer experience by a lot. And I think it's also going to change the way that we use TypeScript. Because, for example, in TypeScript 5.7, the TypeScript team releases a new flag that finally supports TypeScript runtimes like Node.js, Pan, and Dino, so that you can use the .ts extension, and when you compile, it will rewrite it to the .js extension.
How do you think the packaging community is going to be seeing this? Do you think everyone's going to be writing TypeScript from now on, or they're going to keep writing in JavaScript and let user land do whatever they want?
So this has been a bit controversial because we don't want to allow package maintainers to publish packages fully TypeScript. We still want package maintainers to compile into JavaScript. This is because there are several reasons. The first one is that you might have different TypeScript TS config options, so it might be incompatible, but also because of the IDE that needs to perform type checking, it needs to go deep into your Node modules, which is not good for performance, and there are a lot of other factors. So we still want NPM packages to be published in JavaScript, but if you have an application for your company, you can write it in TypeScript and it should work out of the box.
Nice. I saw the roadmap that I'm going to put in the video description later, but I saw type stripping, it's going to be the one thing to go. So do you think we're going to have like TypeScript configuration files or adding more complexity, or this is the way to go from now on?
So I hope that this is the way to go for runtimes. I also created an npm package called Amaro, which basically performs the same. It works in the same way that the Node core does, but I plan to add more features there. Yes, config support. So everything, it will be an external loader. So an npm package that you can download, but it will be maintained from, by Node core people. So also that if people want to get involved and start contributing to it, that's a good place to start.
Amazing. This is the whole thing right now, right? It's experimental. So we need people who are watching now to help us understand what we could do better. However, I've seen like a lot of suggestions, a lot of ideas, and some things that I've never thought about it. So it's amazing how the community is not like a one-man job, right? It's the whole community listening to them and finally get it worked. Yeah. Amazing, Marco. So thank you so much for being part of this. I'm going to need you, who's watching now, to comment here if we should try doing some podcast with Marco as well, because imagine how much and how many ideas we can get from here, right?
Thank you.
All right. So if you have any last words for the audience, what do you think for the future and how you're expecting this whole thing to be in the next few years?
Yeah, so please give it a try. We need feedback. So if you want to start experimenting with it, please go ahead. I think this is the right way, and hopefully it will be standardized in the future and types will become a part of JavaScript.
Amazing. So thank you so much and until next time. Marco is an incredible person. I've had many great conversations with him at events all over the world. And if you want to know what's happening with Node.js before everyone else, I highly recommend subscribing to this channel, leaving a like, and of course, following Marco on X and other social media platforms. For the Show Me the Code part, I created a project that uses a design pattern called Generic Repository, where you create abstractions or templates using TypeScript generics that you can reuse in your code to iterate all behavior without having to duplicate code all over the place. Shall we see in practice? All right, first of all, you're gonna need to use the experimental strip types flag so you can start using TypeScript files. All right, so here I did something a bit complex just to show that we are actually using TypeScript right there. So I have a bunch of folders, and let's see for repositories here. So I usually have an interface that tells us the contracts the repository should follow. And in the base repository, I have something like an abstract class. So I have all the implementation here. And if I want to create a repository, in this case for product or the student, I'm going to just extend this function and inherit all the functions. So if I want to use this base repository, I'm going to just extend this class and inherit all the implementation right there. So let's see in practice. Here, the product, I'm going to say, wow, I'm going to just have the class and extend the base repository and say, what is the type I'm going to use for this? Once I do this, the product repository is going to have all the functions from the CRUD for us. So if I need more and more domains here, more entities, I'm going to have the same idea. So for student, same thing. The only thing that changed is the type I'm going to start using there. Well, for services, I did the same idea. So I have an interface with all the contract, what my base service should implement. And here in the base service, I'm going to have this abstract class that's going to have all the implementation. And notice something interesting here. Here is not the same code from the repository. Here I'm going to use the dependency injection for repository and just pass through all those functions. And then for using them, exactly the same idea. So base service is going to use the product and so on, so forth. Nice. The last thing I'm going to show you is the factories. So the factory design pattern is the place that we create all instances for our project, right? So here I'm going to get the repository. I'm going to have the service and just return the instance so I can start using them right away. And then in the index.js, I can actually execute this function. So there what I have. Well, I'm going to need the instance from the factory with all the dependencies I have. I'm going to initialize the entities I'm going to use later. And notice, a student service is going to have create, student service is going to have update, delete, and so on, so forth. So I create it from one side and just reuse on our main class. All right, let's see if this works in practice. So first, I'm going to check what version I'm using. So I'm using the Node.js 22. So this works on 22 as well as in 23. And then I'm going to run npm start. So I can see this works right away. And I don't see any building, any additional files right there. However, notice one thing. Well, we know that the names here works pretty well, right? TypeScript is working behind the scenes on VS Code. But what if I change this name right here? TypeScript is going to show me that something is wrong here. However, if I save this file, I won't gonna see any problem. I'm gonna see the value is undefined. So the TypeScript in Node.js, the whole idea is to help you with IntelliSense and the time you are writing code, not actually executing it. All right? It's amazing to witness and follow changes in such large projects like Node.js, and to see that the project's direction is always aligned with what people want and ask for. If you want to learn more about JavaScript, TypeScript, Node.js, performance, best practice, and all for free, check out my Programming Academy. If you want to learn more with me, there are a lot of playlists with content in English, also in Portuguese, that you can follow along with subtitles and learn JavaScript and Node.js from the source. For you who made this far, comment here, I'm here, so I know you stuck around until this point in the video. Also, let me know what kind of videos you'd like to see in the channel. I'm thrilled to bring more and more content in English so you can enjoy as well. I invite you again to check out the playlist here in the channel. They are packed with amazing content that you won't find anywhere else. I hope this video has exceeded your expectations. I'm Erick Wendel, and I'll see you in the next video. TypeScript running natively in Node.js? Yes, in this video, I'll show you how it, which has just released, how the support is working the version 23 from the Node.js project to this video. To explain why this has finally happened. Agora tá rápido demais. For this video, I've created a relatively complex project to show you that I've let two awesome. Não, deixa aqui, não vai fazer sentido.